Welcome, Spikelings, to the Shark Typhoon.
Lands, like, get that utility instead of just having these, but it's gonna be pretty close either way. Brittany's on a mold to 5. Brittany plays a different Goblin combo. I mean, you can play the Snoop combo deck too, but, like, Cauldron isn't great with Snoop combo. I mean, you just, like, tap, turn a thing into a Snoop if the Snoop is dead. You could turning your stuff into Sling Gang Lieutenant's kind of interesting. I don't know. I'm open to it. I'm open to it for sure. But I just kind of really don't want to play Grim Gully is my thing. Okay, so up against Tron with a hand that's not great against Tron, but they're on a mold of 4. We have a Field of Ruin. It's probably not going to be all so bad. There's a good infinite mana combo with Cauldron Modern. Well, we're playing the Rona combo. It's not necessarily a good combo, but the combo is kind of like all good cards, which is what's nice about that build. Uh-oh. Okay, good news that they're cracking. They're actually getting punished for cracking the main phase because now I can cycle my Kling. That being said, and like, I don't know, we'll see what happens. Like, they are going to get Tron online before we can Field of Ruin them because they're on the play. We can't play our Voidwalker this turn, although holding up Shieldred's Edict is relatively safe against, like, a Karn the Great Creator. Cauldron plus Tamashii. I don't know, Cauldron is really good, and you can do a lot of brewing with it. Tamashii is also a good card. There's kind of like just no end to the brew possibilities, you know. I've been working on Kiki Jiki Cauldron, a lot of different builds with Kiki Jiki Cauldron. I've spent like probably like 5 or 6 hours overall trying to figure it out, and I think there's also a reason why you haven't seen a good. I don't think I've seen anybody else figure out a good build. I've seen a lot of bad builds. I'm still working on it, but not convinced that there is a good build out there. You know, Andrea once said, no deck ever got better because a player added Kiki Jiki to it. My favorite hobby outside of Magic? Probably D&D/ Pathfinder. Just more gaming, all gaming all the time. Oh, I should have done this. It doesn't matter. So if I do it on their turn, it doesn't matter because they just tap the tower, pop the relic. They can pop the relic now. It's the same actually. How do you keep track of my paper collection? I just have all my good cards sorted by name and color, and then I just pull them when I need them, and then kind of deconstruct the decks after. And I don't really have any decks built at the moment. Luminarch Aspirant and Mono White Cauldron decks. I like Luminarch Aspirant, or I have liked it. I think the card has gotten, unfortunately, much, much worse since the card has gotten a lot worse. It's gotten a lot worse with Bowmasters being printed. I don't think it fits the Heliod deck, or like I don't think you should play it in the Heliod deck, and just kind of tough. So good of them to use all these cantrips before I can get my Bowmaster down. What about just Krinko, Cauldron, Hastelord? Just? What do you mean just? That's so much, and so much worse than like other Cauldron decks, you know what I mean? I do think you could play Krinko. You could play Krinko in a Goblin Shell, but one problem is like getting it in the graveyard. It's a, you know, freaking 4-mana spell. Good Voidwalker here. Transform interaction with the card. Yeah, I mean, trying to build around like giving like a transform card an easier transform ability doesn't sound very competitive, but it sounds very fun. So they're not rebuilding their Tron here. They are playing another Karn the Great Creator, though. If they minus, I can kill a Voidwalker. They could kill a land, I guess. Oh. Just not killing a land. We'll take it. I could go Bowmaster plus Sign and Blood and then kill the Karn, but then I'm giving them 2 cards, which is kind of awkward, to say the least. Let's go ahead and cast this now. I want to, at the very least, be able to get... Oh, but if I do this, then I can also... I can't cast the card with the Voidwalker, actually. Yeah, I would have to attack it still. Okay, I'm down to just ping the card to one, put them in a spot where they can't get, like, O-Stone with it. They've got one card in their hand, doesn't have Trons. It's probably fine. They have to find their third tower off this, which is not that likely since there's only two left in the deck. Honestly, Krinko Cauldron, like, what a title. Krinko, oh, they do find tower. Is their last card a big payoff? I think it's O-Stone. Yet again, my opponent has plessed with the Karn, with the coding in play. I guess, like, no, just nobody gets card coding, so nobody knows how it works. is maybe what's happening here. I guess I probably should have Thoughtseized first. It's okay, we can still Thoughtseize. Can't really imagine their last card is relevant, though. Like, they could have Ulapogged. Right? Yeah, they have 10. They also didn't Gigant, though. I do think we should Thoughtseize here, though. Like, they're thinking for long enough that it seems like they have something over there, right? Warping Whale, my Bowmaster. Sure. So I'm probably going to go Karn for Needle here. Let's see if we draw a land. And they've already used two Karn the Great Creator, so we can go Karn Needle, Karn Liberated. Kind of weak to them drawing a Ulamog, but we at least have Shieldred's Edict. Karn Liberated. Why didn't Kia Karn coding work? So you have to coding the land and plus Karn on the land. My opponent just, they're coding my lands in my upkeep instead of just killing. They twice coding, upkeep tapped the land with coding instead of just killing it, which is... incorrect in these spots, I think. Surely O-Stone is scary here. O-Stone is not scarier here. I can give you maybe a couple minutes to try to figure out why it is I wasn't scared of O-Stone. I think I'll play the ring here. I can maybe attack with the ring next turn. Instead of playing my Voidwalker. Yeah, turned off from the Karn. Have they given Planeswalkers passive ability since war? Yeah, all the time. Tyvar is a recent example. Yeah, the new Ashiok has one. It happens pretty frequently. They're just, like, more balanced. They got Ugin. Well, Ugin doesn't kill my colorless stuff if they minus. I have Edict to kill the Ugin. Ugin went from, like, the scariest thing you could ever face to, like, it just feels like it almost never does anything. I don't know. Maybe it's probably good. It's good. It's four color, probably. I mean, definitely. So we're probably gonna end up. It can maybe Voidwalker it. I don't know. I can go plus Bowmaster it, and then also play Voidwalker. Let's do that. Seems like a pretty good line. There are other cards that, like, somehow another Warping Whale good beats. The war's passes are so oppressive, feel bad. I mean, Karn Nurse at Teferi, yeah. There's a whole mess of... there's like 20 of them, though, so kind of bound that a few of them are too good. Yeah, we lost to Coffers. We were playing this deck. We beat Coffers once, lost to it once last league. So still up in the air, which deck is better, huh? Okay, so you have a couple break the ice, which is nice. I'm going to cut my pushes, I'm going to cut my blood chief's thirst, I'm going to cut the victim of night, and then click submit. I'm going to bring in a chalice. The miserable double mana Nissa. Yeah, that card was pretty dang good, but I don't know that it was... It's probably, maybe for standard, it was a bit oppressive. I think it was like fine for all the other formats. Do you think Narset is main deckable in control? Almost. I would definitely have like at least one on the sideboard. Yeah, I think on the play I can play Chalice. So we have a Field of Ruin. This hand's definitely kind of slow on the draw. We don't have a Thoughtseize. Don't have a Break the Ice. Can't be Mulligan though. I'm gonna keep seven. I think on the draw, on the hand, I think on the play, I think I would keep. On the draw, I think we earn a mulligan. This hand, I think, is a lot better. Guess I could have played Urborg turn one. Doesn't really change much. What is this keep, dude? This is a 7-card keep, double power plant? You're out of your mind. I don't know, maybe the thinking is against this kind of deck. I don't know. Just easy mulligan, to be honest. How the four main board Voidwalkers felt. I'm not close to cutting them. Yes, goodbye, Lucy. She graces us with her presence again eventually. It's always like as soon as Esther walks by, she's always gone. What's the rationale for 3 Cyborg Turok? The card is the best card against 4-color Omnath, which is a very, very, very popular deck at the moment. Also comes in like a variety of other matchups, like Control and Titan Intron, so and Living In. So like, despite it being like very, very good against that deck, it's also like a very versatile sideboard card, which is makes it a card you want to play a lot of copies of. Third Ancient Stirrings for Urza's Tower. So their hand is still Karn Liberated, Sanctum of Ugin, 3 mystery cards.
Are you too relaxed? Are you misclicking?
There was like one game I played real bad because I was real relaxed, yeah. But overall, not too bad. Remember, against Sphere, you have to have the Bowmaster in play before they crack it, otherwise you don't get your Bowmaster trigger. Or you can't respond to them sacking this with Bowmaster. It has to already be in play. Okay, so Sanctum Karn, 2 mystery cards. Deck for 2. And I think we just start off by cycling a Cling to Dust and seeing if we have better info on which 4-drop we might like to play. It does feel like their hand is kind of weak to go for Turok. I think if their hand was maybe a bit better, I'd be more down. Could have also gotten Shield of Pre-Combat to make me make them crack the Sphere. It's also like we're not getting Tron next turn. We can go Voidwalker into Turok next turn. Yeah, I think this matchup overall is okay. We've played a good amount of it. It's, you know, you're a Voidwalker Field of Ruin. Field of Ruin deck, it's kind of hard for it to be bad. So they grab a tower before the Turok ability resolves. And then they draw a card. This is very odd order of operations here. Then they discard the tower and a Sylvan Scrying. Wait, how did they had map and scrying? Or maybe they must have just drawn the scrying off the sphere. I don't know. People always talk about how easy Tron is to play. Tron is so easy, everyone says. Why do Tron players all make so many mistakes? Then why do our Tron opponents always make so many mistakes if it's so easy? I don't know. They're trying to keep something. Hopefully, Dingo and Jesse and Nathan aren't watching. Well, Nathan's probably at least traveling back from Vegas. X-Grave, thank you for the Twitch Prime. Hope you're doing well today. Another four-color Omnath opponent. I'm very excited to play this matchup more. We played against the Bring to Light build and, like, crushed them. How many people are in Super League? There are 16 people in Super League. And we've just finished the first round. We're going into the winners and losers brackets. I'm in the first round of winners brackets. It's gonna be 2 weeks of winners, 2 weeks of losers, and then if you go win into win, you get a pretty long break because there's like a last chance week into the top eight. Solemn with the gifted sub to Dingo. Let's freaking go! Hell yeah, Dingo. Yeah, you can switch up your deck list each time you play. You're not like, I'm not like locked into my scales list that I was like kind of metagamed against Reed on Yawgmoth a little bit. I do kind of like that this matchup is like, this deck draws cards, this deck punishes deck for draw cards. It's a fun dynamic. Extra prime sub for the grindy matchups, hell yeah. Classic problem, what do you do with Teferi against a Bowmaster? I asked Eric if we put Super League splash art directly onto Moto. Be kind of interesting. Okay, so let's just draw a card, see what develops. Okay, fourth land is nice. We're just gonna go play Bowmaster, ping Teferi, attack Teferi. Also, congrats Dingo on, or sorry, Anurag on the Brainstorm win. That's crazy. Is there like any chance you're keeping the Brainstorm? Because I feel like there's few people in this world who would appreciate it as much as you do. But I can't imagine not selling it. Think of all the Twitch subscriptions you can gift. Yeah, I know. It's just like irresponsible to keep it, you know what I mean? It's like no piece of cardboard is worth $20,000 or whatever. But I will say, like, if anybody, like I don't think anybody who's like spending the money on it can appreciate it as much as Anurag could. So a tough spot. There's Omnath, two mystery cards still. Looks like they have a binding. kind of an interesting spot where if they binding the token, they can ping the Bowmaster, but that still kind of ends up with them down. Maybe they just want to like be able to, maybe they don't even care about using the Rin like that. I'm not sure. And then I think I play Ring instead of Shieldred. Like, I need to play a 4-drop. I guess I could just... No, I can't push because there's Teferi. I'll do this. And then we kind of make the binding a bit awkward. Like, they're either giving me a 2-for-1 with the Ring, or they're not casting the binding now. The next one I can go Shieldred, push the Omnath. Okay, so hand is Omnath, and then it'll be two mystery cards after their draw step. Kind of nice we have the Cling to Dust too, so like, obviously not as good a card advantage engine as the Ring, but we should have stuff to do with our mana for the next couple turns, no matter what happens. Am I ever not pinging Teferi here? I think it's just too risky to not ping Teferi. Just really don't want to give them another minus. They do have a fetch land, you know, if they can have, obviously if they have a really nice follow-up to this, we are unhappy. Looks like a solitude if they're shocking here. I can't really imagine it being not solitude at this point. Yeah. Which is kind of nice that the Bowmaster is eating the solitude, not my Shieldred. Let's see what we draw. We draw the cottage. So I'm going to get to push Omnath, attack Teferi. Possibly this is a trade. I think they're more likely to trade if I play Shieldred first, because they know they can't really attack with the Solitude. And they've got one card in their hand. I have two, and I've got the Cling to Dust. I've got the Field of Ruins. I've got the Cottage. I can even like go Cottage back Bowmaster, Cling to Dust, draw the Bowmaster next turn if I draw a land. Second Omnath. It is funny how Shieldred lines up well against Omnath. Like, it's a 4-5 against the 4-4. I've always kind of liked that. Probably not going to be Field of Ruining too aggressively here, though. They do have spells in their hand. Let's Thoughtseize, I guess. Wow. So we'll see if they want to chump block. I'd be surprised if they chump blocked. And then I'm going to Cling to Dust now. I'm going to target a Fetchland of theirs, I guess, because those are the only cards they care about being in their graveyard. And then we can hope to find the third Thoughtseize. Not super likely. More likely just going to be passing the turn here. Okay. Do I want to Cottage Bowmaster now? I don't really think so. I think that we have like many, many better draws, to be honest. Okay, so the hand is Beanstalk, mystery card. I feel like I would have always cast the Beanstalk before the Ren and Six here. Yeah, well, why are they? I guess they're trying to thin? Because like, what if you just draw a land and off the Beanstalk wouldn't be able to fetch on my turn for more life, right? I've been playing Marvel Snap almost every day since I picked up the sponsorship. I've been infinite the last three seasons. Okay, we definitely need another good draw. Yeah, no companion from them, so I'm not sure what they're playing over Kahira. Maybe Nissa. Nissa's really good. They're attacking. One card in their hand. Well, damn. I think I'm attacking them. Oh yeah, the Bring Talos plays Norn. Right. Oh, I can't actually go. Field, and Cling. I'm one mana short of escaping the Cling. So the hand should be Fetchland mystery card, right? Omnath is getting them so much life. Weird, right? Okay, so let's go ahead and Field of Ruin. Not their triumphs, because I don't want them to cycle them. But I want to Field of Ruin now, so that... Wait, is this Escape 4? Escape 5, right. I want to do this now, so that they can't use like their mana in their second main phase if they get a land. We could have gone field, fetch, Cling. I mean, I'm one short. That's what I was saying. Not that this, like, they're going to get me kind of no matter what here. Wasn't killing Wyrm with it because of the life gain it represents? It's just, like, not that hard. They have another land in their hand already. Like, isn't it gaining more life by me, like, attacking it for four? That they already have a land in their hand that we know about. Okay, game two. What is a great matchup versus Omnath right now? I don't know why people always act like it's, like, this big mystery. What's good against the Omnath deck? Like, Isn't it just like always like Chon, Titan, Living Ends, you know, Coffers, like these kind of decks? I don't think this matchup's too bad, to be honest. Like, again, up top, it's not too good either. Like, just like anything is not super favored for this deck. Not super unfavored either. It's got like a little up top deck there. Yeah, big mana burn. Yeah, I guess people just don't play a lot of Modern, but yeah, that's just kind of always the answer. Big mana decks, combo decks. Storm, we're playing the blue-red Storm deck with Rings. Like, that deck was performing really well, and just like Omnath is just a buy for that deck. Titan's not as good against it as like some other things we've listed, but I have to imagine it's still favored. Okay, let's. Don't think I'm really ever just cycling the Kling on my Marsh Flats here. It's kind of awkward to not have that fuel for the escape, and then I want to be able to potentially Kling to Dust a fetch land that my opponent will get. Although I guess that's a little bit less likely, since like, am I going to do that instead of casting my Orcish Bowmasters? I'm not really sure. Could Thoughtseize also? I think I'm just gonna cast my Bowmaster. If they have Beanstalk, Bowmaster is really nice. My true brewing in Legacy with Cauldron. I can't brew in Legacy. Legacy is a format that you have to play a ton to be able to like realistically, reasonably innovate it. It has to be like your main format. And like at one point I was a Legacy expert. Legacy is kind of unrecognizable. And there's just too much nuance for me to just like casually pick it up and brew around a Modern power level card. I guess I'm gonna Solitude my Bowmaster. Must think I'm a Coffers deck. Kling to Dust should be pretty good here. If they just go cycle Zoggoth Triumph, pick up Zoggoth Triumph. So funny that they boarded and crumbled to dust against the deck. My mana base is almost all basic swamps. like, this is, like, nearly a blank card against me. Nearly a blank card. Okay, so what did they draw that my opponent is not going to cycle Zoggoth Triumph? Leyline Binding, maybe? So if we think maybe it's Leyline Binding, this Turok has gone up in value a little bit. Yeah, they thought I was Coffers. I just, you know, not an unreasonable assumption by them. So you know, not exactly binding, but it was a one mana removal spell. Had good chance. This is also kind of the nice thing about Turok: when they bolt it, you get to cottage it back, and then like next turn we get to go cottage back Turok, Thoughtseize, Shieldred. If we feel like there's a chance they're going to have a spell in hand, which does seem somewhat likely if they're going to cycle Zoggoth Triumph. Although now we know their hand is, oh no! I should have done a better job of maintaining this. Because I thought I clicked rid of the Windswept Heath. Like, I think their hand is Windswept Heath Triumph right now. But there is a Windswept Heath in the yard, so I'm like, did I fuck it up? Does anybody know? I'm just gonna cast the Thoughtseize, I guess, but yeah, I didn't fuck it up, I just doubted myself a little bit here. Just gonna take the beats. Yeah, there were two. There were two. I didn't fuck it up, but I wasn't quite focused enough. Yeah, I know Turok hit Heath and Strand. There was just two revealed. Or is there one revealed, one was like maybe brought back by Renin 6? They have Temple Guard and not a Heath? I don't think so, y'all. Guess we're about to find out. Okay, I believe y'all. This many people are saying it. So I did not click rid of Windswept Heath, or maybe I clicked rid of Temple Garden instead of the Heath, the first time. So I messed something up for sure. But his top decks have been pretty good. Could you play? I'm not playing Murderous Cut in this build because I have three Cling to Dust, but yeah, I have been a proponent of Murderous Cut in the past, of course. Okay, not I guess I could maybe have hit the needle off the cling. I'm just gonna. Because they could draw another Ren and Six. I want to be able to cling whichever Triumph they go after. Yeah, Turok out of Bolt range. They don't really have many answers for it at this point. Sun and Blood is nice. Voidwalker's okay. You know, another threat's okay. Two more threats. Yeah, they are a Bring to Light build. We could be playing a bit too much into Bring to Light for Verdict, but I think against the Bean, we're just gonna try to fade for one more turn. Okay, well, not a Verdict. Not like good for us though. So these should be cutting them off of colored mana here. They can get them off double white. I can maybe just get them off of the ability to Bring to Light for enough. Yeah. So let's wait on the other one because they might be able to get Stomping Ground off this. I want to stop them from being able to find Bring to Light for four. But I'll still feel to ruin them on their upkeep if they don't crack this fetch, I think. Because at this point, I'm not able to stop them anymore for going like Fetch Shock. But if they go to the six, Fetch Shock down to three, then their life total is like really perilous. They have Sacred Foundry. I've already killed Sacred Foundry. I've killed Temple Garden, Sacred Foundry, Hollow Fountain, Rogren Triumph. So I think that they are in theory incapable of making double white anymore. Well, that's not a verdict. I have like 11 unblockable power here. I thought that they had already played their land, because that was because they cracked the fetch, I guess. It seemed that way. Yeah, so they're still in it. Although, what fetchables did they have left for this? Do they have a? They might not have a fetchable. They don't have a Triome. They don't have Sacred Foundry, Hallowed Fountain, Temple Garden, Island, or Plains. Steam Vents? They could have Steam Vents still. I think we saw Steam Vents last game. I think that they're checking. Either way, they didn't have a plan. Fury will be out there. Yeah. Although they can't get double. They can't, like, there's, I guess, Fetch Shock Steam Vents. Does that do it? Maybe Evoking Steam Vents? But also keeping seven. Fetch Shock Vents, Skulltorak. Yeah, so what's their life total if they Fetch Shock Steam Vents? Because they had a ring on two. But it might have been fine. Right, this is maybe a game where I cycle my cling. I They do only have two basics left. It's kind of good to know about. I feel like high probability of a Teferi here. They're a 10. For some reason, I feel like their life total is a lot lower than that. This kind of stink when you don't draw your Bowmasters against the Beanstalk, I guess. Let's draw two. Yeah, no four drops at all. That's seven after land drop. So Fed Shock down to four. Yeah, they could have Fury to stay alive. Yeah, hard draw, just not as good at punishing. Can't punish the ring, can't play our own ring yet. Can't Thoughtseize them. Can't do anything. Guess we're just dead. It feels tough to like just not draw a Shielded Ring or Bowmasters, but it is what it is. I hope they cast an Omnath. Childred is maybe not enough, but maybe with the Thoughtseize it is. Okay. We got a plan. Kind of seems tough for them to only have one. Okay, well, got some work cut out for us. I mean, they take two. If we had a Turok here, if like a Turok would have been pretty nice to take the Brain to light. Hard for them to kill it. Wander, 3 months. Thank you. Welcome back. So they're taking three more. Casting Valky. What praise on the three-card being deck? Tron, Coffers, Storm. Alright, if I draw a Bowmaster. We can keep playing. I think anything else will just concede. Well, I don't know. Like, if they just have an Omnath, like one Omnath in their hand or no Omnaths. Turn to envision. No, it's just gonna concede. Just gonna concede. Let's move the fuck on. Take verdict. I'm gonna concede. I mean, we're 1-1 against it today. What do you want? I guess the other one was the Scapeshift variant, but it's a pretty similar deck. I don't know. We've also played a ton of like pre-bead against it. It's not really so bad. Wooded Foothills, Sacred Foundry, Ragavan. What is that? Wooded Foothills, Sacred Foundry, Ragavan. I guess just some brew. Domain Zoo. Domain Zoo usually plays Gigantha, but that could be Domain Zoo with no Gigantha for some reason. Yeah, Boros Ephemerate, although usually you see white fetches instead of red ones because of Blood Moon. Yeah, so now, like, basically locked in on Domain Zoo. Certainly after this. Field of Ruin might shrink this territorial copy, I wonder. I think we don't Field of Ruin now because Bowmaster can, if they just choose the loot ability, We get the ping. Some zoo people have been playing Fury. Interesting. It would be really nice if we had the Bowmaster in our opening hand, because we could have pinged this and then pushed the Kavu. Reason for... Yeah, historically I played Night's Whisper over Sudden Blood in these shells in the past, because it is very tough. Sometimes where you keep a hand that's like Field of Ruin, Swamp, Sign and Blood. But the thought is that in the against the four color bean deck specifically, you really want to be able to Sign and Blood them. I think it's important for the matchup dynamic. That is how it played out the first time we played the matchup today, but not the second time. Beanstalk, huh? So yeah, so they're playing Beanstalk and Fury. Okay, Bowmaster triggering twice so far. We'll trigger a third time if they have like a Solitude binding, or binding more specifically. So I guess I'm playing Shieldred here. So if they take their draw, they like no longer can cast a binding. If they cast binding, they die. I don't know like what what it is my opponent can hope to do here, really. Yeah, I guess there's always that option, just concede. Why not ring first? This is why they're just dead if I cast the Shieldred. And if they're somehow not dead, I still have the ring in my hand. That was like good backup, but they're just fucking dead. Okay, bring in these Victim of Night. Yeah, we did beat Tron earlier, although our opponent was making a lot of mistakes. Could have drawn Tribal Flames. I mean, if they draw Tribal Flames, they're at 4 life with Bowmaster Beanstalk in play. And then I just untap and cast the ring, you know what I mean? Narset is playable right now, but Narset's gotta be pretty fucking good. I kind of wanted to play it in Bant Beanstalk. At the very least, I'd be playing like at least 2 on the sideboard for that matchup. Don't know what to take. Take Beanstalk, they Scion. I don't have a clean answer to Scion for a little bit. But I guess I don't really care much about their Fury or their Lightning Bolt, so... Like, taking this also makes like the rest... It just makes the rest of their hand worse, and... We're not pressuring their life total as well as we were last game against the Bean. Just take one of the threats. I don't know, it's like the Bean makes up their threats. I guess if I take the Scion, the Bean is worse. We do have the Blood Chief's Thirst here. We may just be taking a couple hits. Awesome, Ben. Very cool. Yeah, I'll probably end up going to Vegas next year, assuming there's another Vegas. Seems like they like doing one every year. Yeah, if I knew I was drawing Bowmaster, I would probably leave them with the Beanstalk. They shock an Overgrown Tomb, so I guess they're just going to cycle Zoggoth Triumph, or... No, there's something... Okay, now they're cycling Zoggoth Triumph. Got it. I don't know why I thought it was something else. Could it be correct to Field of Ruin, then Kling, or Kling first to try to draw 2? Keeping them off domain is pretty nice, but I think I have so many 2 drops, or 1 drops like this. Let's just do that. So we're gonna go down to 8, then down to 7, and they have the Bolt of the hand, and the Blood Chief's there. So this is really the crucial top deck for them. Aver, 23 months now with more chat yelling. I think less because of the couch, but yelling developments maybe. So they haven't done anything yet. Then do another Tribal Flames, of course. Half the Blood Chief's Thirst. I'm dead if I Shieldred. Arcanist Fury, Lightning Bolt, Mystery Card. The Mystery Card's a land. It would have made sense for them to just do nothing and try to untap, cast Fury. If that is the case, not sure. Like, I guess we'll obviously just see what we draw and figure out what the best plan is, but I'm hoping to not have to, like, just run the Shielded out. Oh, they drew Tribal Flames. Well, I guess that makes things easy. We are dead, but we don't have to think anymore. Okay, on the play for game three. Let's run it back. Running it back. On the play. I would love to Thoughtseize them and see a Ragavan in their hand. It is really cool how, like, Ragavan is, like, the super inflammatory, like, controversial card, and all of a sudden they just print Bowmaster, a card that everybody loves, and it feels like just nobody hates Ragavan anymore either. It's like, there's just, like, I think just is, like, exactly enough counterplay to Ragavan to where people aren't worried about it so much anymore, but also it's still, like, a playable modern card, just kind of in the sweet spot. The one mana spell, I guess. Yeah, everyone loves Bowmasters. It's kind of for, like, a card that is just, like, immediately one of the best cards in Modern and punishes a lot of stuff. It is, like, pretty universally loved. Obviously, I'm sure there are some haters of the card. There's haters of every card, but I think it's rare that a new card is so good and powerful, but people are like, yeah, that one's pretty dang. We love that one. Dingo and respect the cat hates Bowmasters. Really? Dingo hates Bowmasters? Not worth playing March because Coffers. I mean, I kind of think March sucks just in general. Like, even when I play Coffers, I don't like to play March. I know everybody else likes to play it. It's okay. It's not like it isn't the worst card ever, but it isn't a card that I like very much, and it's certainly not good without Coffers. Fatal Push, I think, was universally loved. Yeah, maybe. Yeah, I think legacy players probably hate Bowmasters a lot more than modern players do, huh? Dingo wants Bowmasters banned. Really? I'll ask him about it during Super League. Man, I get to hang out with Dingo and Jesse and Nathan on Wednesday. It's gonna be a good day. And Brainstorm winner, Anurag. Land? How has the one victim not been feeling? Just like two mana kill creatures. That's exactly what that card says. Am I liking the black green? I would rather play this over the black green shell. I think like, Halfling is very hot and cold. And then Dread Knight is also, like, very good in against, like, specifically Scam, but I think struggles a lot with how much exile-based removal there is at the moment, and isn't feeling incredible. And then also, like, your mana's worse, and it's the whole thing. But, I mean, that deck was also, like, it wasn't bad. If you want to play, if you really like green-black, you can still play that deck. If you really like Coffers, you can play Coffers instead. I don't exactly hate Bowmasters. I don't love how it piles onto making one toughness creatures awful in Modern. I don't know. There still is, like, a density of, like, playable one toughness creatures. Like, and that, ugh. This is, like, the best Fury I've seen in a long time. I think, like, the list of playable one toughness creatures hasn't changed very much. Like, it's still Ragavan, DRC, Esper Sentinel. Actually, it has changed. Now there's an extra playable one mana creature, Orcish Bowmasters. Now there's an extra one. It actually broke the barrier. But I don't know that there was really any one toughness creatures that stopped being played because of Bowmasters. Maybe just see a little less play, you know what I mean? Hierarch is essentially gone. Yeah, but Hierarch is gone because of Halfling, more so than it's gone because of Bowmasters, but people also, they still do play, it's kind of a funny draw, people still do play, like, High Orcs and Yawgmoth sometimes. You know what I mean? Not that High Orc was, like, was already, like, super fragile. Any chance I want a cottage back? Something? I don't think so. I know they have tribal flame, so I think I just want to play ring and then put myself in a position where I can go shielded, gain four, and then like their tribal flames is just so bad. Like I kill shielded, I just play another one. See if they have a binding. That would really put a wrench in things. They don't though. Amy, thank you for the raid. Hope you're having a good one today. Playing some mono black mid range and modern. Enjoyed your world coverage this weekend. Our ring has been tear asunder. We know our opponent has a tribal flames over there. If I sign in blood myself, how bad? I think I'm just gonna play a shit. We're just so ahead on cards that I think the main way we're gonna lose is to like getting triple burn spelled. Oh, we could also just do this. We just go Shieldred, the Tribal Flames. Oh, Bowmaster Sign of Blood is 4, not 5. I like how little of you had a camera in a good time. Let's see, we're covered in dogs. Yeah, we were covered in dogs earlier. Not so much at the moment. Yeah, I think this is my first sofa stream. I'm kind of liking it for today. I'm not... Oh, but the Bowmaster ETB. That's why it's 5. I knew it was 5. I'm not married to the... to the sofa stream, but I'm kind of enjoying it for now. I mean, we may mix it up with, like... I probably need to, like, stand some amount of the streams. Like, I knew it was 5 in my head, and then I did the math, and I... All of a sudden, it wasn't 5 anymore. Come on, your mystery... Oh, I guess they had 2 mystery cards, huh? That should be okay. We can, we get to put them to 2 and just start casting Shieldreds. Thoughts on Hearth Elemental for Dredge. It's definitely something I would be trying. Sorry, mystery sub, Tej, but I would definitely try Hearth Elemental and Dredge if I was a Dredge main. I'm not a Dredge main, I haven't played a ton of the deck, and I'm not really that interested in playing it on stream, to be honest, so... I would just encourage you to give it a go. Alright, if they have a binding, they have to have another binding next turn. They do have a binding. Will they have another binding next turn? They get a loot with the Kavu. This would be a rough game to lose, dude. This would be a rough game to lose. Oh, I did play the wrong Art Shielded. Damn it. Oh, okay. This was... They're dead. Now binding just kills them. Right? What am I missing? They have to have, like, Remand, which I have seen them play before. And they even know about their... That's okay. Yeah, I think they were supposed to loot first. Not that it, like, super matters. It will be funny if they have the binding and they die. That's crazy. Thank you, cottage. Is it crazy because they're killing it? No, it's not crazy because they're killing it. Oh, okay, they are though. They it's funny. Ha ha ha. Beanstalk, terrible card. Makes you draw a card. I was not expecting to have a murderous cut. Makes sense though. I like it. Kind of medium in the deck. It's okay. Opponent's on a mulligan to 6. We're on the draw with a pretty good opening hand against modern decks. I think I'm not supposed to push this. I'm not sure though. I think I just take a hit, then Bowmaster it. Like, I could push a Fable Token, I could push a Voidwalker, could potentially Clean to Dust like a Scammed Fury. If they think I'm Coffers, which I guess they probably wouldn't think I'm Coffers. Green Black, Tiber, Cauldron, Priest, Pioneer deck. Yeah, I've also been kind of working along. Oh, sorry, I should have fetched a response. Working on that a little bit in Pioneer, and I just keep coming to the conclusion like, oh, I'm trying to build around an artifact in Pioneer in the like turn three Karn the Great Creator format. It's just like there's just so much more Karn the Great Creator in Pioneer than Modern. Seems tough. Seems like a tough ask. Getting Blood Mooned. Could have maybe played a Marsh Lots here, but I really don't mind getting Blood Mooned here. I have a ton of swamps in the deck. Have some stuff like this. Yeah, we'll hold up the Kling and still potentially. Well, no, I'm going to cast it now. Like, with three cards, they're really unlikely to scam me, but they are just more likely to draw a Bowmaster, which punishes me for holding the Kling. I think. If their three cards are, you know, Grief Black card, Undying Effect somehow could beats, but that's just more likely to better to play around Bowmaster, right? I'm actually kind of happy to play against Scam here. We have the first time playing against it today. I know Nassif was beating up on it with the Kling tech, and I'm kind of excited to see how it's feeling. We are playing one less Kling than Nassif was though. Still a pro everything. It's still what the ring says. Although they can Voidwalker, but I can just edict my Bowmaster, I guess. And if they had played Ragavan, then the edict isn't nearly as good here, so they actually do get pretty punished. It's funny though, because like they like, it seemed like for a second they forgot about the ring, and then they're like, oh wait, I got a Voidwalker this Bowmaster. So I draw two. They have a Ragavan and a mystery card over there. Still pretty choked on black mana here. I'm just drawing all my fetches and fields. Not the second swamp yet. They dash the Ragavan, I should be able to Thoughtseize it if I don't draw anything else. My life total is still comfy enough, I think. They flip a Voidwalker from my side, which is pretty relevant. Ragavan back in the hand. Down to 11. There's a second swamp. Could it ever be better to Thoughtseize? I don't know. I have a hard time imagining. Hard time imagining it is. It's like they have. I'm dead to Bolts. Like top deck. I guess I could Thoughtseize the Bolts. So they must have drawn Terminate for turn if they're going to draw step that. Maybe they just didn't have an upkeep stop set. Now they get to cast the Shielded. It's kind of an annoying hit from the Ragavan, I guess. It certainly felt like we were super ahead. I missed the damage. Thank you, opponents. Nice of you. Victim of Night. Just dead. Lost to our own cards, huh? Maybe lost because I didn't play my fetch turn 2. Okay, I'm going to be bringing in the Victim of Night. It's really nice to have. Like, one thing besides just, like, killing Murktide and Titans and stuff, having more answers to Fury in your Fatal Push deck, I think, ends up being a pretty big deal. Bring in the Hearse as well. Go down to, like, one Voidwalker. Could even play, like, one Turok. I think it's maybe enough. Too many four drops to play a Turok over the Voidwalker. First Voidwalker is okay. Yeah, if we had worse cards in our deck, their Voidwalkers would be worse. Oh, it's so awkward to have tapped Cottage plus Cling here. I actually think I have to mulligan. What do I play? Upheaval? I've played one Upheaval deck on stream. It was one of the worst decks I've ever streamed, but it was really cool, so kind of got it out of my system. I was playing Song of Creation plus Paradoxical Outcome plus Upheaval in an Urza deck, and it was, the deck was really, really bad, but it was really, really fun. When I got to do his thing, it was really cool. You would just draw your deck, Upheaval, then play four Urzas, and then have four Karn Strux in play, plus a million zero drops. Those are my favorite cards. Yeah, I know, like, that's why I made the rare exception for a content deck, you know. I started the stream like, this deck is awful, but I have to get it out of my system. And that's exactly what happened. Okay, opponent's on a multi 5. Take it. Alright, maybe unban Mox Opal, but you have to put you have to be main decking for Upheavals. Where can you find the Upheaval deck? It's probably on YouTube. It is in the Mox field somewhere. You can dig it up. But it's maybe best left hidden, because that deck sucked, and I wouldn't want anybody to be like, this is a deck I got from Aspiring Spike. I guess I'm taking Grief, since the other two cards I don't care about at all. Arcanus, copy of the opponent, you cut a copy of the ring. Well, I'm not playing the ring in the mono blue deck there in the sideboard. I don't know, like, why would you play that over Gristlebrand, right? You could play Gristlebrand in the mono blue deck. I think I saw a screenshot of someone playing, like, a similar list, and they were playing it too. Maybe I'll just discard Bowmasters if my opponent croaks us. Hopefully they just play Blood Moon, yeah. Good Field of Ruin here. I think that's fine, because I want to discard Bowmasters to Kroxa, so I can have Edict still for Kroxa. Maybe giving them an extra card for Kroxa is awkward, but also, yeah, they also may not have a Mountain, which is kind of funny, like, they have no red mana with Blood Moon in play. Okay, let's draw a card. Oh my gosh. I missed the graveyard. I missed the wrong. It just popped up my graveyard when I clicked the Cling. It's such a bad misclick. It's like not the biggest deal, but a pain. And I don't have the Cling for the Grief. Just like, what have I done? Still pretty ahead. So I'm going to take my Shieldred, and then I have to decide when am I going to Bowmasters. Probably Bowmasters next turn. So I'm going to try to kill the Grief. It only costs 6 instead of Gristlebrand's 8. Yeah, it's only a 6 drop. It's only the worst 6 drop you've ever seen. You're realistically not ever casting it. It's like 6 mana, do not. 6 mana, when I untap with it, brother. Drawing some cards. Got one card in their hand. Pretty dang a bad card, I'll tell you what. How often am I trading this hearse for the grief? It doesn't seem like now I have to because I drew this bowmaster. Draw three cards on your creatures. Yeah, I appreciate the thought. It doesn't seem very good, like overall, like better than playing a Gristlebrand if you were gonna play that kind of effect. And it's always like these kind of ideas that are like sound very cool in theory because we're just talking about the good situations where everything goes right and we get to draw three cards, but. You're also putting Arcanus the Impotent in your deck. Card that I would really prefer to not register. Oh my gosh. Just clicking buttons at random here. I decided I didn't want to cling on my turn. I thought for sure I clicked Undo twice, but I guess either Magic Online didn't register a click or I didn't click Undo twice. Draw a card. Maybe they have a Bowmaster. It's kind of these spots where you're like choosing to play around Bowmasters or choose to play around discard can be a little weird too. I'm dead next turn if they don't have Terminate now or next turn. Yeah, they think we're on coffers. You do get like a surprising amount of like splash damage. Like we had an opponent board and crumble to dust against us today. But like yeah, coffers is, you know. Alright, going to game three. I hope one day someone gets to name Not Dead After All with Pithy Needle after someone names You Are Already Dead. That's awesome. I hope so too. Well, this hand is kind of soft to Ragavan, but what do I think about Elusive Utter and Prowess? I think it's worse than Questing Druid. Questing Druid, I think, is really good. We played like two leagues with it on stream when it first came out. I liked it a lot. I think the formula for Prowess is like more or less solved, and I grow kind of weary of just playing like the same formula with like very small variations. I do think Questing Druid is really, really good. I think it's better than Sprite Dragon. But access to blue mana can be important for sideboard cards, especially if Living End is popular. This guy is generally where I'm at. And the deck overall I don't think is like particularly well positioned. Fuck. I guess I take Voidwalker. They dash Ragavan, I can Thoughtseize Ragavan, maybe. Very interesting that they led on Thoughtseize with this hand. I guess, are they just scared of Bowmasters? Or I guess they could have Thoughtseized it on turn two. I do need to prioritize fetching two Swamp. Not a fan of Turn the Earth against Living End. Fuck no. I guess, as Prowess? That's your plan? Turn the Earth? Play Tormod's Crypt, like, the very least, but, like, the problem with that matchup, the problem with, like playing green as your hate against Living End, and you can play some chalices, but it's hard to play four chalices. The problem is, like they still get to kill all your creatures. Like if you just go Tormod's Crypt them, Turn the Earth them, they still get to kill all your creatures, and that's not good. And like you just have no follow up, and then they still win anyways. Although I kind of hate Turn the Earth in general. I'll say that too. I think that card is really dang bad. I think Turn to Earth is my pick for like the worst sideboard card that people play regularly because it just seems like it should be good, but it's so ineffective. I think it was a joke. Yeah, maybe it was a joke, but they've given me content at least. Thank you for the content. Well, your draw lined up well against mine. Yeah, Pulse is okay in Jund, but it's. Otter seems like a 2 of that maybe opens up lethal attacks. I hope it opens up lethal attacks. I haven't cast Otter yet. Otter could be like a bit more impressive than... Man, the top of my library has been kinder to them than to me. Auto could be better than I think. I think it certainly feels like the ceiling on this card is just... I should guess could have done this in response. The ceiling on this card is just kind of low. It's just kind of low. And your super removal heavy four color scam Bowmaster Ridden Six, just like so many cards line up really well against the Otter. I have a hard time imagining that it's like this heavenly card that just blows our minds. Yeah, I was thinking about playing one coffers in the stack, but I wasn't sure. I just don't really feel like you need... Like, without Karn, like, the coffers are a lot less important. Well, hopefully this trigger resolves. Big. Is Damnation in this version? I just already have 8-4 drops, and... Shielded Ring usually stabilizes most board states. You could play one. To activate that castle there, Lactyl is going pretty low. Please have Not Dead After All instead of Lightning Bolt here. No, they have Bolt. Come on, dude. Oh, they have a second Fury. That's somehow worse. We're still not in the worst shape ever. I'm going to draw a card. Game 2 instead of just game 3. Does get XL, that's okay. I'm gonna sneeze. Not gonna sneeze. Sneezing. Oh yeah, but then they just cast my Shieldred again. This is the second time they've cast my Shieldred with my Voidwalker. It's not fair. I haven't brewed any more on the Aragorn Gutshot Lava Dart idea. I may get around to it at some point, and I may never get around. It's kind of late, like, that card came out a while ago. Oh, they're casting that before Shieldred? It's kind of nice, I guess. Okay, so... We can draw our own Shieldred, we can draw a Fatal Push, we can draw a Victim of Night. Okay. Mission accomplished. Hopefully they scam it and it comes back to my side. That would have been awesome. So we draw another Victim of Night, so we get to go... Bowmaster plus Victim. So they did have a Not Dead after all, but this is like why I wanted to cast this in the upkeep, just in case they had it. Get this tapped. Why do you think Ephemerate doesn't see much play anymore? It feels like Ephemerate was everywhere for years and now it's gone. I don't know that Ephemerate was everywhere for years. Ephemerate has always been a really, really powerful fringe card. Like, I'm trying to think of like a time Ephemerate was in like a tier one deck in Modern, and I can't really like think of an example of a time where there was a tier one Ephemerate deck. It's very powerful, but it, you know, it's kind of fragile and slow, and like the plant, like the slow, like Ephemerate your stuff plan doesn't always line up well against the Modern format, you know. So let's go ahead and Yorion? Sure, yeah, sure, Yorion. Although a lot of the Yorion list did not play it. Yeah, they could be dead to Sign and Blood. I want to play around their own Bowmaster here, though. So I Sign and Blood them. I can just attack and also not give them a window to draw off my Sign and Blood. Like four color has played it, but like the most popular versions of four color usually didn't play it, or like they would play like one copy or two copies. Despite, like, you know, it would have been pretty reasonable for them to play more. Like, I think most four-color Yorion lists didn't play the playset. They would play, like, They would play some number. Elementals, yeah. But it, but to say it's been everywhere is a little bit of an exaggeration. Okay, let's get a prediction going. I've played it everywhere. I've played it a ton. What do you get from being mono black without coffers? The good black cards. Like, it's just the same deck with better mana and a better sideboard. Yeah, like, this is the coffers deck with better mana, better consistency. And, you know, I think that's nice, you know. You curve out of four anyways. You just really don't need coffers so bad. Why have I stopped playing it? Do y'all think that I... I don't know. The reason I haven't played much Ephemerate is because I'm out of Ephemerate decks to play. I always like to be doing new stuff, right? Or, like, you know, this is, like, you know, pretty updated list of an old deck we've been playing. I think the last time I played the Ephemerate Bant deck we trophied. Maybe move away from Grief's game. It was really in the Seif's list. The Seif's non-covers black was went away from it, and I like it. Like, Grief is kind of awkward. There's so many four drops. Malakir Birth as a tap land is rough. Playing like Undying Evil, Not Dead After All with only Grief as a target is rough. And there's just like a lot of problems that arise with Grief, and like obviously you get some good nut draws, and like the Grief plan is pretty good with the Witch's Cottage plan, but in a lot of ways I feel like it kind of things just end up being a lot smoother without it. All right, I think we take call. Well, so I guess the Voidwalker turns off the Cauldron Familiar combos. So we take Manufacturer. Wasn't there a Mardu scam list a while back where it's three color? I can't recall ever seeing Mardu scam with the Ephemerate. Like, maybe that's exist. I just can't recall it at all. Red fetches some for Moon. I would not be able to withstand splashing something. Well, that's fine. You can be not with Able. We've literally played that. We've played this deck splashed red, and I've preferred the mono black version. Like the Field of Ruins are really, really good. You don't want to be playing Blood Moon in your Field of Ruin deck usually, and I would rather just be playing Fields instead. We've splashed for Fable, Ragavan, Blood Moon, and this has been better. We played a lot of different versions with mono black no coffers, and we've done a lot of winning with mono black no coffers. So it is nice that Voidwalker should stop them from comboing unless they hit like Grist. Sack Outlet. Oh, it's the Lonus deck. Oh no. Okay, that's a big board state. And so Chatterfang can kill my Voidwalker when they get access to a mana. Jolt 2. The top of my library has been not so kind. So I can ring again for protection. Am I dead though? So they have 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yep. They have another goose. I'm sending this over their way, I guess. Gonna be a tough one to win. I will admit, but the matchup overall is probably fine. Then this deck would have challenged this weekend. I wouldn't be surprised. I'm not sure. Like, Nassif has played the deck a lot, likes it a lot. Like, the mono black coffers deck is like good, established, and has a lot of like, you know, accolades to it at this point, despite people still not really respecting it very much. I think that's true. We found the bad victim of night matchup. Although I'll probably bring it, still board the extra copies in. What if we ever cast Coco? Yeah, so let's draw two. Victim of Night, the Chatterfang. See if they're going to sack a squirrel to kill my Voidwalker. I'll cast a Collected Company. I have cards I could hit. I found one Hive pretty good in the deck. Mono Black has infinite utility lands you can play. I'm choosing to play Witch's Cottage because it turns all your fetches into utility lands. But you can play Hive, you can play Takanuma, you can play Shizo, you can play Mirix, a land that Nassif was liking. You can play Blastzone. It's all fine. I'm just choosing to play Cottage, and Cottage means that you don't really want to play. Oh, and I can play Chatterfang. I mean, that's a 3/3 right there. So I play my 3/3 block here, take 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, go to 1. Right? 5, go to 1 after the ring damage. You can block and kill. So block and then give something else minus one. Yeah. There's not really a big difference between being at one and being at two, though. I guess Cauldron Familiar is the difference, but they tap their Dryad Arbor, so we're still, I think, going to one if they Alpha Strike here. And obviously, we kind of just have to draw Shieldred, but we draw Shieldred off of. No, we draw Shieldred off of. Oh, they just don't Alpha Strike. What the fuck? Okay. So it should be better to go push Bowmaster than to Sign of Blood, gain 2 life. Yeah, the downside to those utility lands is it makes your cottage isn't good at that point. It could be better to play those utility lands instead of the one of cottage. I think it's very close. I think it doesn't matter a ton, but you absolutely could. I think Shizo is like, it gives your Shieldred like hexproof. It's really not that big a deal. All right, let's go ahead and push the. How is this being tapped right now? Oh my gosh, Lotus has an ability. I forgot about this. Target opponent reveals top X cards of the library. Put a non-land permanent with mana value X or less among them. I totally forgot about the Lotus's ability here. But it doesn't matter because they don't have enough food clues. Okay, never mind. That's why I forgot about Lotus's ability, because it never does anything. That's right. I like Cottage and Coffers. Yeah, but like, y'all, okay, Coffers players, y'all should be playing fetch lands, if, like, anyways, because you're a Fatal Push deck. You should have some fetch lands, but like, why are the Coffers lists just not playing fetches? It's really staggering me lately. Just unlocking me. Thought they could have attacked. I was opening up company just in case I needed more blockers. Because if I untap here, I'm going to win. So I just wanted the possibility of Coco to block. Oh, Forest Walk. It's funny. Okay, that is Sign of Blood. I won a lot of games with Sign of Blood. Okay, we won that game. Somehow. Oh, because my opponent fucked up. That's right. I recall now. All right, despite Victim Knight having a card in my opponent's deck, it can't kill, let's still bring it in. Could be a good Ratchet Bomb matchup. Bowmaster seems pretty good. Team of God, I think with the 4 months, hope you're doing well. We got the Sign and Bloods, we got the Shieldred's Edict. Just submit this. You think you ever get bored of Magic? I've been bored of Magic before, but the way I interact with the game, me like always like building new decks, innovating on old decks, talking to chat, it makes it very difficult for me to get burned out. I get burned out, like, I like, to me, like going to FNM or doing a draft on I have friends who draft like every Monday. I just don't go that often because I would rather do other things in my free time than like casual Magic. But this stuff I just never get sick of, dude. Until I get scammed a bunch, then I get sick of it, actually. Just small disclaimer. Yeah, it can't kill a Viserysir in this matchup. Ran into it. My graveyard keeps like trying to block for their graveyard. I'm gonna play the Voidwalker, just like Sam isn't too scary with Voidwalker in play. Yeah, I don't know, Scub. We got that question earlier, and I did not. So it ends up working out. Like, a lot of content creators, they, like, kind of have to keep doing the same thing over and over again to keep an audience. And, like, I'm not, like, really immune to that. But, like, thankfully, the thing that I'm supposed to keep doing as a content creator, or, like, what I'm incentivized to keep doing is brewing. And so I get to do a lot of new things all the time. And doing a lot of new things all the time is a really good formula for not burning out. Okay, let's just attack and pass. Do you have any opinions on the name Scam versus Red Black Evoke? Yeah, I kind of feel like Scam is just not inflammatory enough of a deck name. I would really like it to be something like fucking bullshit, fuck this deck. Fuck you, Scam. Something along those lines, or I just feel like the deck name is not nearly inflammatory enough. That's okay, Bower. Yeah, I know I have a dumb username or whatever. I picked a username 10 years ago, and now it's my username. But yeah, this is really, you know. Aspiring brewer, or let's brew in modern. I don't know. If the goal of the stream was to just like play the deck with the highest win percentage all the time, we'd be trophy racing all the time, and I would, you know, hate my life. All right, so they're gonna sack a squirrel, basically trading this for two squirrels. They got two cards left. If we can draw a land, they're gonna be in bad shape, I'll tell you what. I'm not really gonna Pithy Needle Chatterfang, am I? Maybe I will. Maybe I should just have Victim of Knighted the last turn. I'll do this. Although I should probably main phase it so they can carry on. Not used to playing around this card. Uh oh. Guess that's fine. So they're hitting me for a good amount this turn. They're hitting me for 7 down to 5. If I draw a land, I'm just like, Bowmaster cleans up 3 of these. Yeah, I might have to cast their Chatterfang so I can get more squirrels of my own to block. They only have one card in their hand. I did draw the land. So let's go ahead and just Fatal Push this first. Then cast Chatterfang, then pass. I don't know, the Aspiring Spake username has always been like a little bit of a joke. It's always been like kind of making fun of the, like, you know, everybody in this chat. See, making fun of the like kind of sweaty F&M hero. Like they take like a lot of pride. Like, I'm a Spike, dude. I'm fucking great at this game. I'm really good. I'm a Spike, you know. It's making fun of that while also fully acknowledging that is who I am. It's, you know, I don't know. That is also me. It's, and then also like there's a little bit of just like wanting to improve and wanting to get better, and there's a few different elements of the name. Man, this Chatterfang mirror is crazy. So I guess they could Chatterfang my Chatterfang, and if they want to trade their squirrels for all my one drops, that's fine, I guess. Oh, but they get to make one more squirrel, so they actually get to hit me for one here. Oh, they kill Bowmaster? Bowmaster is like a lot. Why aren't they killing my Chatterfang? I don't know. I feel like this card is really good right now. Could be missing something. Okay, we have regained the Chatterfang advantage here. They've got no cards in their hand. They're in top deck mode. Gaining some life, doing a main phase, a little bit ring flooded. I guess I'm gonna need a Gilded Goose. I could not tell you the last time I pithy needled a Gilded Goose. I also get to attack because I am making another squirrel. One or more tokens. Oh, right. It's tokens, not creatures. So. Never mind. Okay, I'm going to name Gilded Goose. And this is creatures interest too. Okay. So let's not attack. Well, they are on a two turn. I attack them. They have so much life gain. Yeah, never mind. Okay, so they can't. Needle, okay. Not really so scary at the moment, I think. Isn't it a mana ability? Yeah, I'm not needling the mana ability. I'm needling their ability to make food tokens. This time they're not sacking their food. Top deck's company, though. It's huge. Into now that my opponent has regained the Chatterfang advantage. Unfortunately, they've snatched it from me. We do get to this like chain rings together pretty hard though. All right, no, I forgot they have the Chatterfang advantage. Okay, gonna be a tough one. So if I cast Path of Peril, we reset the Chatterfang. We're back to Chatterfang neutrality. Then my life total is kind of like, oh. I can play another ring next turn. Can also cling. They also get to bring back a Haywire Mite. Swish, thanks for the raid. Hope you're doing well.
We need a Godless Shrine, brother.
I think we can cast it. They have the Goose Man to kill my squirrel. No, they only have three squirrels total, so if they sack a squirrel, they can't kill it, right? Yeah, I would love to be dead to a top deck Javamaya Forest Walk. We die, just don't we? No, because they sack a squirrel. This gets minus two. It's got three toughness, brother, and we should be fine, right? They can't make a food because I've goose needled. Sacrifice X squirrels. Oh yeah, I mean if they sacrifice the Chatterfang too, this is good. Then we're Chatterfang neutral now. Neither player has the Chatterfang advantage. Oh no, the Chatterfang advantage. Okay, so I can't thought seize them either, or I die. Well, I could thought seize them and then cling to dust, but then I'm still dead. Man, the intricacies of the Chatterfang mirror are crazy. Yeah, well, I'm okay, but I was in theory okay with that that decision point. Okay, so I'm gonna sack a clue. And then draw collected company? Fuck. Kind of, I don't know. Not casting Chatterfang this turn. Something. They have Bowmaster in their deck? They must have Bowmaster in their deck. Nope, no, never mind. Change their mind. Well, I'm gonna cast a ring. And be unsure how well positioned I am. Or I suppose I should have fielded the saga first, sorry. We have Kling. Yeah, I know we have Kling. It's 4 mana to escape though. It's pretty good Coco, I guess. I would assume that's a good Coco at least. Pretty big if they somehow like can get down to. I guess they have enough food to get in life too. Ooh, fetch Dryad Arbor. May have to settle this in game 3. I'm trying to figure out how I can sign and blood them to death, but it seems very unlikely. Okay. Court for Cauldron Familiar. Okay, they're gonna get something else, but I would. Okay, they do get Cauldron Familiar. Okay. Fun. Protection doesn't protect me. What a gamer, huh? Go down to Kling. Can't they kill your shit with Chatterfang? I don't know. I don't know. I was mostly just trying to envision like a path to victory, and my Jedi visions just kept coming back with Shielded Sign of Blood. Speaking of Jedi visions, Esther has finished the prequels and. She loved them. She loved the prequels. I do too. I also love the prequels. She has gone from like kind of lukewarm on Star Wars to like really really liking it and wanting to do a Star Wars costume for Halloween. We're not sure exactly what yet. Keep, I guess. Let me take that right there. I think we're gonna do like Ahsoka and Anakin, maybe. We've been watching Ahsoka. Ouch. Ouch indeed. I could push for the Samwise. I think I'll take the Manufacturer. I think they're far enough away from company. Oh, they didn't fetch Dryad Arbor, they just drew it. All natural. They kept a one lander. They did draw 2 lands in a row. They drew 3 lands in a row. Must be nice. So I'm gonna go upkeep, field, have push up for the menu, or if you know, they played the Manufacturer, but. Or we thought he's the Manufacturer, but can push Sam or any other 3 drop they play. It could also be like light on basics. But yeah, they also probably don't have, they may not have Swamp or Plains. They might have Swamp or Plains, I guess. Alright, they have the Chatterfang advantage, but thankfully we can bring both Chatterfangers back to Chatterfang neutral. Sorry. Right, their hand is Sam, Coco. They can't cast either of those cards at the moment. I'm gonna slam a Shieldred. typically good when your opponent's behind on board and can't cast anything. Goose does unlock both cards for them. I have the option of Field plus Voidwalker or double Voidwalker. I think I am just always going to double Voidwalker here. Down to three, which is pretty good for my Void Walkers. They both deal three damage. Kind of thought they might chump block the Shieldred, but what's the Lotus combo? Their deck isn't really a combo deck, I think. It just, well, it's combo. They have Sam combo, but like Lotus is just like a value card, and it's like a value card that doesn't like really give them any value, or not much. It's okay. It's fine. It's like kind of like Samwise. They're ahead on the Chatterfang board. We may have enough to beat Chatterfang this time. There is one with Lotus. Lotus combos Manufacturer the same way Samwise does. Oh, yeah, sure. I mean, like, was like the normal like Sam combo plus like a bunch of like token doublers. I don't think it does anything like super, super different. Okay, so we got not as good chests this time. We got a one rank last time, so can't complain. Back-to-back 4-1s with Mono Black today. I'm liking this build. I think there is maybe a little question mark in, like, are the other utility lands better than Cottage? I like Cottage. It's maybe somewhat close. I mean, I think it is somewhat close. I'm liking the sideboard, though. I'm liking the deck. I may play it in Super League this Wednesday. I think I'm going to go ahead and raid Hob today, who's just getting started. This is a really good day to raid Hob too. So Hob is doing what is known as the God Run 3, which is trying to beat every Souls-like game in a row without taking a hit. So Bloodborne, Demon Souls, Sekiro, Demon Souls, Elden Ring, Dark Souls 2, and Dark Souls 3. So he's currently on game 5. He's done Bloodborne, Demon Souls, Sekiro, Demon Souls in a row without taking a hit. A single hit will send him back to the very beginning of the run. So very exciting day to be watching Hob. Oh, it's also my 3-year sub, which is very cool too. So I will see y'all later, and goodbye. I'm